Good morning, guys. It is fucking bright and early. It's 5:30 and I look really, really tired. But I woke up at my first alarm went off at, sorry, 5. You know, I like bolted out. I was like, oh shit, thought I overslept because I only went to bed at like midnight. So I have like, what is that, 4 hours sleep? 5 hours? So, that. I'm still undecided if I'm going to wear, as you can, wait. Let me, if I should wear this shirt or this three-quarter gray one. So, a little bit, I don't know what to wear, but that's not the main concern. I need to do, re-straighten my hair, put my face on, pack what I'm taking into the con today, and then I can get a start. Because it's, fuck's sake, it's gonna be a big, big ass day. Look at that bright light, show you how tired I am. Yep. So I'll probably get there by like 7. And then I'm pretty sure the event doesn't finish till like 10 p.m. So it's like, what's that kind of day is that at 5? 12 plus 5. Come on, math. Come on, Dan, good at math. 17-hour day? Then, yeah, do it all again on Sunday. So, watch the update for now and I'll see you when I'm radio. Hi guys, okay. It is now 7:01. I am ready. I decided on this with a little red flannel. And yeah, Selena just messaged me. She is nearly done. I'm about to head down to the lobby and so I can meet her there and then we can walk to the convention center. I'm gonna try and vlog in public again. If not, it'll be when I'm in the center and yeah. It all just depends on how my anxiety goes. Sorry that I'm blowing late. Didn't get a chance at all today. It was a bit chaotic. You would have seen I've inserted some pictures of what I took at the panels and what the pictures I did take wasn't that good. I took them on my iPhone. Tomorrow I'm gonna try on this camera. I'm gonna take them. You can't film anything in the panels, can't film anything in the photo op vendors room, so can't really film a lot of places and like I go in the corners. I had a lot of photos taken today, but I'll explain that. I'm running late. It is 10 past 8, the concert starts at 8:30. Yeah, me and Celine gone back, we've changed. I basically just changed my top. Still got on all my gear. And then we're gonna go down, try and get some food before the concert. But I'll be filming the concert, so you'll see that. And I will talk to you after the concert about my day, okay? Bye. Look, there's the boys, and we could see people inside. Look at them. There's old people there. Oh, it's blurry. I'm gonna let it de-blur. You're gonna go. Okay. When it decides to de-blur. Celine, you wanna say hello? When it decides to stop de-blurring?
I don't think it's any pink from the cold or embarrassment.
I would say both. Hey guys, so Selena's behind the camera. We are heading to the convention again to do the concert. There's a lot of people coming ahead of us, that's why Selena's filming. I'm quite embarrassed. See, this is what happens, it's good with someone else. Might pause it because I'm getting very anxious right now.
Thank you. in law.
You on it is currently, sorry, I've been on Twitter and my room service just came and my milkshake's over there. There's a lot of mess, don't worry. Behind the camera where my actual suitcases are, that's even worse. So what if, yeah, it's just gone past 11 and I might put you down as usual. Oh yeah, you can just see my mess of a room. I'll have a little turny. And okay, so as I was trying to explain, yeah, you can't really film in our panels. You have 5 minutes to take photos and that, so I did try to do that today, but in my photo ops, which are in here, which I'll talk to them about soon. I got my autographs, but I'll do those stories first because they're pretty easy to get through. Had my VIP panel, it was very, very good. The, trying to think what the main points were so I can skim through. The boys were, they looked very refreshed. They didn't look actually too jet lagged, not like in All Hell Breaks Loose 8 where they were really jet lagged. But as I do have one photo that I bought today which I have to get done tomorrow, and that's my squishy bear photo, and I think I'm sharing an R2M with Brooke and Lucy. I have changed in my PJs but I still got makeup on, but it's because I'm too lazy. I wanted food. This is my, is that hot? I gotta burn my finger again. I burnt my finger on the breakfast one because I put my finger in the hole to lift the lid and it fucking burned the fucker. So I'm letting that cool down a bit. It was only a track. Yeah, panels were great. We kind of went, the boy, Jared and Jensen couldn't find the entrance to the convention center. They were apparently driving round and they couldn't get in for half an hour. So that kind of pushed back the schedule for like, what was it? I think we were 20 minutes behind, 30 minutes. So that was that. And that's why a lot of the squishy got pushed back. I think the boys just had enough. They just did their duos, the singles, and they went to, I would say, rest and eat, because if you heard me talk about All Hell Breaks Loose 8, you'll understand, because I was in that room and I knew how long they were in there for. This one was a lot better than 8, I would have to say. Hub did way, not order, Hub did a lot better at controlling from what happened at 8. I'm in the lines and I still hear people complaining. Don't know if they'll ever see this, but Hub, I love you and you do amazing work. And I love, everyone was just, the funny thing was, at the end was autos. Everyone was like, they do Jared and Jensen first, and then you go into another room, and there's Matt, Rob, Rich, Ruth, Rachel, and Julian. Poor Rachel was at the end. They should have put her at the front near the door. She's so lovely and nice to everyone that she has a full-on chat with you, and her line kept going. Like, we were like a snake. Everyone else was just like, in, next. So we were stuck in line for Rachel's autograph for about an hour or over. That was a bit draining, but people complain, I don't, you just, I'm not even gonna get into it because it's just, I will get into my little autograph stories. Oh, I've already bent something. So if you do watch my videos and you are on my Instagram and Twitter and all that, you will know that last year, because it was a couple days before my birthday, I got my cake smash photo. All of these will be in better quality on my Instagram, so don't worry about that. But I got Matt to sign it. I printed this out. I was too lazy to go to Kmart and get a real print in time. And then I was waiting for Matt to recognize because he's the one that actually smashed it in my face. He didn't. I'm blaming it on he was tired. Rich actually remembered. He's like, when did we do this? And I was like, last year. And he's like, oh, it turned out well. It's good. Like, yeah, yeah, thanks. Thanks for smashing a cake in my face. So that was that one. I just kind of got Jared, Jensen, and Rob to sign my journal thing because everyone has signed my poster. The only new ones I got were Jillian, Ruth with a faded pen, and Rachel somewhere. Where's Rachel? Oh, down the end. I think I got a quick signature because they kind of told her to move it along by the time it was getting really big. And oh, my shirt that I had on for the day, Rachel loved it. Mainly because it had a little Hogwarts theme to it. And I'm sorry, I'm gonna take off my bra so it's easier and more comfortable, because who needs bras? So that's autograph story. Oh, and when I got to Jared, I thanked him for everything that he's done for me, and I kind of blank on what he said that, but before that, when like I'm the handler and we're handing this to him, he's like, oh, hi sweetheart. And I'm like, No, sweetheart was in the photo, I'm sorry. He said, hi, sweetie. I was like, that's twice in one day. I got that. Because I'll remind, in the order, the photos, which I will quickly run through because I don't know how much battery my thing has. And I really want to eat my food. This was my free gift from the Hub because I was a platinum ticket. It's a vinyl with two Jason Mann songs. It's one side has When Did I Stop Believing, and the second one is Journey Live. Only problem is, I don't own a record player anymore. We had one like before we moved, like three houses ago. So now I need to find one, and a cheap one. So there's that. First in my photos was Rude. She's so tiny and cute, and there's a glare, but like I said, this will all be on my Instagram by the time this is uploaded, so you'll be able to see them clearly if you want to. Yeah, but just full on, like, it's in and out, like, it's kind of like, hi, how are you, pose, out, in like cattle, as I say. So I have that one, because you get the first three, and then they let all the course go, and they call you up again. I got my Rich, another Rich hug. There's nothing wrong with simple, because it's, look at us. And either I have grown since the last time I saw him, or Rich has shrunk, because think I'm taller, or we're the same height. I don't know. I got my Matt hug. You can't. And Matt had a beard, like a the fullest beard I've ever seen him with at this con. I love hiatus beards on the guys. I wish they could keep them forever. But we always can't get what we want, and that's just something. But there's nothing wrong with a Matt hug, you can't do it. But the only problem is that he had a long sleeve shirt on today. You normally you could see. You could see. But you, And then we were allowed, when we got caught up, to do Jared and Jensen. You could either ask for a hug and that would be a pose, or you could actually ask for poses. There's a rule over here in the hub that you can't actually ask for poses or hugs, like the guests are meant to hug you. I don't know what, I know there's different rules over at Creation, and I'm pretty sure it's like the Germany one and Jib and wherever, but we're here in Australia, there's a no hug rule. But generally you get hugs because the guests like to hug you and they go off your energy and all that. But my pose, I wanted to do, like, because I've kind of hugged Jensen, I've had my Jared hug, and I wanted ones where it was more like kind of intimate, where it was just mainly me and them looking. So I was like, can we do, like, I did this pose for both Jensen and Jared. Did Jensen first, and like we said, a little high, there's always a high and thingy, how you are. And I showed this out hands, and that, oh, his eyes are so, and his freckles up close, and it's just, does look, it's really cute. And then I did the same, I'm really surprised I didn't cry after Jared. Also, when I went to leave Jensen, like, they're not allowed to hug you if you picked a pose. So I went to say goodbye, like, I said thank you, and I was trying to move my arm, like, from behind. Like, after that guy, like, trying to move my arm. And he went for a hug, but I kind of walked past him because I'm not meant to, so I don't know if he was going to try to hug me. He was like, I ain't getting in trouble for you, Jensen. I'm sorry, I love you, but I ain't getting in trouble. And that does. The only thing, yes, my hair is in my face and all you can see is my warm nose, but look at his adoring face to me, and I feel like I'm gonna cry now. And he's holding my hand, and I'm holding his, and it's just, am I going to stop now, because I really will, and that's, I think that's still my favourite. Okay, and then I got my duo, which was the ladies with Ruth and Rachel. I like it. They are just lovely, lovely. I've heard a lot about them online of how lovely they are, and meeting them in real for the first time, it's just like, so that's this. Then I had, after that one, I had my Julian solo, and he, let me just say, Julian is not what I expected. Like, he's so, I don't know what the word is, I'm pretty sure it starts with an E, but I can't think of it right now. Expectations were blown away from him, so. And then I had my Rob one. Now, something went wrong with Hub, and I think it was only a certain time frame of when you, but I actually have two of the same op. It's got it printed twice. Yeah, just my little Rob hug, and it feels great. I just love Rob. He's such underrated, I reckon, and it's just, I love him, and I just want to protect him with the world because it's Rob. Okay? No one can tell me that. Then I got my Rachel. I didn't know she was a hugger, but apparently she's a hugger. So I love that. And then I have, after that one, there's only two more guys, so don't worry. I didn't actually go all out this time. I had to budget. I got my All Hell Breaks Loose 10 group shot, as you can see, and I knew Matt was doing something, I just didn't know he was doing that face on it. And yeah, basically, I don't know what people do in the back. I knew, I don't know what Rachel was doing either. I didn't even feel her, so it's a lot of things that you kind of like black out. It's really annoying because you kind of want to remember this shit, but you don't. And then my last one for today was my duo with Rob and Jillian, which I wanted a God and Death one. I was like, I was kind of pulled into where Jillian's face was, but then the photographer said, no, we can't see your face. So I kind of like moved out thinking he would go around to where my head is and I would be in the middle, but it's not. And you can't see on this picture because it's taken this way and not that way. But Rob had his hand on my knee and it was really cute. But come on, shoot it. But I can still feel it. But that is the main thing. And that is all I have. And like I said, I've got my squishy bear photo tomorrow, which was with Jared Jensen, Robin Rich. And then I'm sharing an op with Brooke and Lucy, and we're doing R2M, like I said. So that's my photos for today. I don't know. And then, yeah, we went to the concert, because that's kind of really the con and all those. It was very, very hard to film, but because I only have two photos tomorrow, I should be able to vlog a lot more. Because even Darren asked me, he runs Gifts for Geek, he's like, did you vlog much today? And I was like, nah. So I need to try and grab him tomorrow because he did say he wanted to be in my vlog. Because hopefully he's free when I'm free, otherwise I don't know how it's going to work. But then that concert, I missed out on the concert last time. If you've actually been following, you know that I had my major surgery around the same time. It was practically 2 months before that con. So I didn't end up going. I was just too tired after the day. But I went to it this time and it was fucking amazing. I only recorded the songs that I knew. So that's all I really filmed. And I just kind of took it all in and was just like, to every other song. And yeah, it was great. Great. Can't wait to see Loud and Sweet again. But that was kind of it for the Saturday. It was very rushed, and no, I should say it's very rushed. It was just a long, long day, and I've been up for a very long, I've been up since 5 a.m. It's 11:20 now. I don't even know how long that's been. I'm probably gonna be up longer because I wouldn't. This is my dinner. I'm eating. I should be fine to eat now. My thick cup chips, and I got aioli, and I don't know why I'm talking in this voice. Why? I hope it's nice. It's good. Probably should have got more aioli. But that's kind of my plans for the rest of the night, and I get to sleep in tomorrow because I don't have to go to the VIP panel. Don't have to be there till like 8, I think. So that's good. And then I'm home Monday. But I think that's all for today's, guys. And I will see you in tomorrow's vlog. Bye. Just as I go to sit down, I remember what also happened after I told Jared that I wanted to hold my, can we hold my hands? Can we hold each other's hands and like look at each other? I don't know. He says thank you, sweetheart, and then he like, I don't know what you want to call it, like a little, it's not really a pinch, but he grabbed hold of my like, thank you, sweetheart, and then I was like, I was just like, it's like the man wants me to cry over him even more. But I'm gonna remember things, and I really, okay, bye. Just the man. I think that's all I have to say. If I do, there'll be more clips, but I'll see you tomorrow, guys. Bye. I forgot to tell you something also really amazing that happened after... Oh, sorry. But that happened after Jared and Jensen's main panel. Okay, after they did... it was like this auction charity where they have these plain cotton t-shirts and they got to draw on them and sign them. And it went to this charity for it went to this kid. He has this disease. I don't know how to pronounce it at all, but yeah, it went to that. So Jensen's shirt, they auctioned it up. It went for $4,000. It was a fucking mum. And so, and then they like had to make them wear them, and then they like rubbed them all over each other's, like it rubbed them all over their skin and shit. So to try to auction more money. So that sold. And then when they had the Jared shirt, it sold for $10,000 to this amazing woman. And then as they was getting close to auctioning, like getting ready, like, you know what I mean? That part. Somehow, yeah, Jared cut his thumb. But then again, it's everyone saying that's probably, he made Jensen bleed last time from a microphone, so maybe it's this time. Jared had to bleed. And so it kind of got on the shirt. So he's like, you got my DNA now. So, and because it got to $10,000 and he felt bad that his blood was on the shirt, he gave the chick that won it the shirt that they drew on and the flannel he was wearing for the day. Not only did she get two shirts for the price, not really a one, but she got his own shirt. And then he like went into the crowd and like thanked her and like gave her a kiss on the cheek and like was touching her face, and he was just so nice and so grateful that people are just so generous. Like, I wish I had that money to like do that, but I don't. That's why I can't go in these auctions. But it was amazing. Like, it was $14,000 we raised for this sick kid, like that. But I think that's all. I'm currently actually going through the tag, seeing what people have posted. That's why it's sparking things in my memory. So, but yes, that's another thing. I'm still going on my chips, but yeah.